Hey, how's it going? New segment of my track day preparation. It's going to be another gear segment. Last one was about my suit and the undersuit that's kind of sitting right there. And today's going to be about my socks. Socks. And what's in the box. Socks box. That was stupid. So, yeah, I ordered some boots. And these came from Sport Bike Track Gear. If you watched my video about my first suit I got that didn't fit, that came from STG. I was really happy with their service, so I was happy to pick something up from them. I needed a pair of boots for the track, and they had a nice pair of boots on sale. I also got a back protector, since my suit does not have one, nor does it have a pocket. So I got one that you strap on like a backpack. And then I picked up these socks today from Big Five Sports. You can get like motorcycle race socks, I guess, but they're like 25, 30 bucks. These were $8.99, and with my 10% off coupon, they were like $8.72 with tax. They're thin, they're cushy, they come up to your knee. They didn't have black, so I got red, because red and black are hot rod colors. And my band used to be called Hot Rod Junkies, so it was kind of an ode to them. Plus, I just like hot rods. Anyway, that's that. Let me open the box. We'll take a look. And then I may try them on. I may wait till tomorrow. I'm starving and I'm tired. Just got home from work. Hang on one sec. I gotta get my knife. Knife. Carefully, one-handed. The more I do this, I guess, the better I get at it. Deeply. Let's see if that was good enough. Exciting. My secret. Oh, more stickers. It was worth it. I love stickers. My goodness. All right, packaging seems pretty interesting. Some kind of like accordion type of cardboard. Hey, force field body armor. Size medium, hopefully will fit me well. This is a CE2 rated back protector, which is supposed to be, as far as I understand, an excellent rating, I guess. Sorry, I'm just tired. And came with the schnazzies, McSchnazzies. Let's see, CE approved, repeat performance technology, multi-density, 3D molding, breathable, fully adjustable. CE level 2. Protection, no compromise. Why should I choose this force field back protector? Alright, anyway, so it's got these shoulder straps. And then a waist strap here. The protector itself, it's a harder foam, it seems like. Very high density. And then the back, it's got this breathable lining. And it's supposed to have a function of when it gets hot or warms up with your body temperature, it molds to your body, conforms to your shape. So hopefully that's going to fit under that suit. Okay, next. RST motorcycle boots. Ooh, look at that. British flag. All hail the queen. She ain't no human being. Let's see here. Look how these are nice. So I'm a size, European size 43, sometimes 44. Like they recommended a 44. That's what these are. These are nice, dude. They were only like $159. Oh, and Sport Bike Track Gear is located in Michigan. No sales tax. So whatever their price is listed at, if you don't live there, there's no sales tax. So it was $159.99 and free shipping. So we got some toe sliders here. These look like they were bashed a little. It's no big deal. Just don't know if... Thought they were used. Maybe it's just like shelf wear. Breathable. There. the left boot. It's for your shifter lever, I guess. Hard protection here, pivots. All right, these are beautiful. And look, they match. That's the most important thing I've been told about. Getting on the track, you have to match. Because if you match, you go faster. That's why I got my red socks too, because even though no one's gonna see them, they bring out the red highlights, and I'm gonna match even better. And that means I'll be faster, right? Right? I'm right, right? Feel free to let me know if I'm right. Hey, these are red too. Haha, that's kind of cool. I'm gonna be stylish. All right, that's the left one. Oh, look, it came with the right one too. These are really nice. I'm really happy. Hang on. I guess it's on both of them. This toe slider is in better shape. These are really nice boots. My biggest concern is, are these gonna shut around my big man calves while wearing this suit that has this built-in armor that's gonna have to tuck into the boot. Hopefully they're designed for that. All right, so here, let me do this. My boots, my beautiful boots. I'm very excited. RST boots, Track Tech Evo 3. 1, 2, 3. But they're cool. I'm gonna eat. I'm starving. I may try these on after I eat a little bit. I'm not gonna try the suit on tonight. But as soon as I'm ready, I will put on my undersuit, my socks, my back protector, put the suit on over that, and then the boots on over that. All right. Sorry if I was a little low-key. Just really tired, really hungry. It's my Friday, and it's late. And I'm gonna go eat. Thank you for everybody that has been subscribing. Thank you very much. I really appreciate it. I'll be back in a bit. All right, hang in there. Hey, quick update. I didn't show you putting the boots on, but they're too small. They're one size too small. They come in European sizes. I ordered a 44 because I wear a 43 or 44 in different shoes. I need a 45. Thankfully, they have it in stock at STG. I placed an order for the new pair last night. I requested a return authorization for these, which I got. It's a no-hassle deal. They just charge you $9.95 if you want to use their return label, which is not a big deal. I have to print that out, slap it on the box, ship this one back. But I ordered the other pair already. They should be here in 3-4 days. I'll show you those, me putting them on. Another quick, nice surprise. These socks I bought, besides being awesome and they fit well, it's two pairs. Hey, I got two pairs of socks for under $9. You can't beat that. And the I tried this on, the back protector fits great, seems to. I'll do this all after I get the boots. I'll put those on with the suit and the socks and the back protector, and you could see it all. All right, so hang in there. Thanks for sticking with me up till now, and we'll talk soon. Bye. Hey, it's about 4 days since my last filming. I sent back the boots that were a little too small. They haven't received them yet. I haven't gotten my refund yet, but that same night, I ordered the next size up because I didn't want them to run out. I think they're limited how much they have in stock. So I ordered them. They just arrived. Actually, they arrived just as I was leaving for work. The delivery guy showed up. So I grabbed the box, brought it inside, and left for work. So they've been sitting all day. Let's try them out. I'll take them out of the box. They're the same boots as the last time I filmed. But these are supposed to be a size 45 rather than a 44. Super secret info. Sticker. I just love stickers. Now I have three of these. That's awesome. All right. RST cycle boots. Can you see all right? Yeah, you can. That's not me, that's the box. There they are. Man, they sure do look cool. Let's make sure they're the right size. Yep, 45. They're the correct boots. They sure do look good. I kind of like how the red matches the red. Matches the red, because that means I'll go faster on the track. Man, these are snazzy. I'm going to try them on. I want to put my socks on, though, that I bought the other day. Did I mention? So it was like $8 and change with the coupon. And it's actually two pairs of socks, not just one. That's really neat. My biggest concern, besides them fitting, but I'm sure they will now, is that I can tuck my leg of my suit in. Can you see right there, my suit? All this, and plus this isn't like a tight grip around my ankle, there's space. So I'm not convinced that that's going to fit inside. So worst comes to worst, I'll just pull the suit over the boots. I think they did that for a few years in MotoGP. So if anyone says anything, I can point that out to them. All right. I'm very happy. This is awesome. Second pair. I'm sorry, second boot. I guess it is my second pair too. Brand new. Everything looks good. Removable toe sliders. All right, let's see. This is the correct boot, right side. Unzip. All right. Paper out. Nice. All right. Can you see? Yeah, you can see. Let me back you out. Right there. Right there. All right. There she blows. Take that sock off. Hey. Sexy. Put this sock on. These are nice, they're lightweight, but they have some extra padding underneath. They come up to the knee, which is all the rage. All right, let's do it. Nice, I already know that that's better. All right. Nice. There's room. Can you see my foot? Fancy. They're comfy. My toe is not hitting the front anymore. They're a little narrow right in the front, right here. But not at all uncomfortable. My biggest question, so I have pretty big thighs. I can't, I'm only about halfway there. And with those tucked in, I have a feeling it's gonna be like way the fuck out. Ooh, way the heck out here. Beep! So, we'll see. I'm not gonna put the suit on right now, I'm tired. Story of my life. Came home from work, but I wanted to try these on. They fit well. My other concern, or question I should say, I wear orthotics in my shoes for arch support. I'm not sure if I even need to bother putting those in, because it's not like I'm going to walk miles and miles in these. I may put them in just to see how it feels. Otherwise, we'll see. Yeah, that feels good.
I'm happy.
Can you see? I'm trying to see if you can see. All right. Nice.
All right, I'll put the other one on as well. But you know what? Let me tuck in my pants. Now I'm official. There we go. There we go. Let me try this other one on. The socks are comfy. And these boots are just big enough too. So now when the weather gets cold, I can wear a thicker sock as well. So I'm happy about that. Hopefully I'll have these boots for years to come. Let's see here. STG, who I bought these from, has a nice video discussing the features. But you know, it's flexible enough, but you have this hard support in the back. You got your toe slider, got this hard pad on top for shifting. They got a good review. They were only $159.99, and because the company's in Michigan, you pay no sales tax, and the shipping is free over $100. So I bought them exactly for the price advertised. Zip that up. Zippers are a little stiff, I would say. Maybe a little graphite on there to lube them would be handy. Come on. There's Velcro tabs on the end of the zipper pull. Ooh, this zipper pull came apart already. That's not good. I'll have to stitch that up. That kind of sucks. All right, here we go. I'm walking fast. Down, down, down. All right, kids, I like them. They're comfy, I can move, I can walk. Next step is gonna be try on the suit. Actually, start from the beginning. Undersuit, socks, race suit, boots. Then I'm gonna sit on my bike and see how everything feels. But that's gonna wait for my day off, all right? Cool. One more thing down, checked off the list, $159.99. All right, thanks for playing. I will bring you back when I have some more updates after I put the suit on with the boots on, sit on my bike. I'm planning to likely have to shorten the sleeves, so you'll see that too. All right, everybody, I'm glad I had a positive outcome. Hey, so real quick about the boots. I wear orthotics in my shoes. These were ones made for me when I lived in Greece. They're kind of a soft insole, but with my arch, and they fit perfectly inside the track boots. So I can wear those and walk around and be comfy, so that's awesome. But that is not what we're talking about now. Now we're talking about HJC number one in the world. The whole world. Everybody in the world knows this, evidently. I bought myself an I-10 semi-flat black full face helmet. It says DOT. It also is Snell rated. And the track that I'm going to recommends that you have a Snell and DOT helmet. My beautiful gold helmet is DOT, but it's not Snell, so I figured, what the hey, what the hoo-ha. It's not really an unboxing. I tried it on at the shop, but it fit well. But I'll tell you something. According to HJC
number one in the world's sizing chart, I should wear a medium. This is an extra large. You heard that right, kids. Extra large. Because I guess it's the shape of my head, you know? About a decade or so ago, I was in the motorcycle business and I worked in the parts department of a shop for a couple years, besides other things. And HJCs were like, you didn't really want one that much. Evidently now, they're number one in the world. And I've been told that most companies, other than some specialty, you know, highly priced companies like Arai perhaps or Shoei, most companies use HJC shells. So for all I know, that's an HJC shell. What? HJC shells, seashells by the seashore. Okay, I'm trying to get this freaking thing out. What's in here? I-10. Not to be confused with the I-11. Oh, it's got an intercom placement, which is kind of cool, although I don't plan on that being my daily rider. But I'll read that later. I do like reading instructions. Here's... Pretty cool bag. I like having a helmet bag. I'm trying to do this one-handed to accommodate you folks. See how much I loves you? Hang on. Look at my boots while I do that. Okay. Oh my goodness. So this is supposed to be a really good entry level helmet for track days. I mean, you can use it on the street as well. But here's the look of it. You got some vents on top, like mini cat ears that open and close. Both of them do. You got a vent on the chin, open and closes. One thing I read about these, which I feel it, very positive lock, open and closed. Listen, you should always securely fasten chin strap when wearing helmet, yo. On the back side here, this is the exhaust vent, I would say. You can see here, this is DOT. Come on, focus, baby. DOT and Snell approved. Approved. XL. Yeah, so this says 61 to 62 centimeters. My head measures 58 centimeters. But it's the shape of my head. And that's exactly why I believe you should try a helmet on if you can. Here's another positive aspect, and it's the first helmet I've had like this. The release is in the center. So it's easier to open and close rather than kind of digging on the side and popping one side open. And with your gloves on, that should be helpful. You've got a breather shield here, vents that come up from the chin up through there. There's cutouts here. I don't know if you can see that. For glasses, maybe, like right there, you can kind of see it. The cheek pads are replaceable, so if you want something a little snugger or less snug, I guess that's the cover that pops off for your intercom. Again, I'm really not going to worry about that too much. It's got just a regular set of D-rings with a snap closure, so that's good. All right, so here's what I'm going to do. I've got everything I need. Helmet, boots, socks, undersuit, race suit. Oh, and here are my gloves. These are gloves I've had for years. I absolutely love these. Icon with titanium knuckles and gauntlets. These are what I want to use on the track. So I'm going to try everything on. And then I'm going to go sit on my bike and see how it feels. And make sure everything works. My biggest concern off the top of my head, these come all the way. Sorry, camera shut off. There's only like 3 fingers of space between the bottom of the pant and the bottom of the shin guard. That's a hard shin guard. Most suits I've seen, the shin guard stops right about here, and that'll, here, headgear. which allows you to easily tuck your pants into your boots. I have a feeling that that's going to be very difficult, and I may have to wear the pants over the boots. Not common, but totally okay. You have seen it perhaps for a couple years or so at the in the MotoGP. So hey, if it's good enough for them, it's good enough for me. Okay. All right, hang on. I'm gonna try all this stuff on. I'll be back. All right, I figured I'd show you how to put everything on. This is the very first time I'm putting everything on all together. I watched a video from Sport Bike Tracker, the people I got my boots from, that walk you through it. Seems pretty self-explanatory, but you know, didn't hurt. So I've got this on. If I wanted to, I could open this up and be a member of KISS, but I'm not. So, got my suit, my undersuit on. Next would be my socks. And this undersuit's a little big on me, like everything else. So I might have some sags and bunching areas, but that's why I want to try everything on, see how it fits, and then more importantly, go sit on the bike and see how I feel on the bike. And then one of these days I'll go for a ride. All right, so socks are on. Next is the race suit. By the way, hopefully it's not weird shadows. I have my ceiling fans on because I'm gonna get really hot, I'm sure. Oh, I forgot to unzip it. Duh. This removable lining is a little, it seems to like it's gonna be a little tricky. Okay, that one's unzipped. Huh. I gotta figure that out. Alright. Man, if you're claustrophobic, I don't know how you do this. So, they recommend you get the legs on, right? Then pull it into place. Zip it shut. Then they recommend putting your boots on now, so you have less stuff. Maybe. What do you think? You want to take bets? Is it gonna fit? Over? Under? Ow! Sorry, I have a cut on my thumb. Got caught in the Velcro. All right. Let's see here. Whew, I already feel bunched up. All right. See, especially too, because these bottom of these pants are cut very generously. They're not like really tight around my ankle. So I don't see how that's gonna happen. All right, so I'm guessing that I will have to put the pants over the boots. So let's get the boots on.
Maybe I'm gonna start a fashion statement at the track. What do you think? No? Yes? All right. And you know, these pants too, I had mentioned, there are two zippers. One has a elastic and one does not. I wonder if that's why it's set up that way. Maybe these are cut purposely to fit over your boots. Might be a little tricky. Maybe not. I don't know. Or maybe it's just a funky suit design that shouldn't have been made this way. Maybe these should have been higher. I don't know. But I'll play with it. I can't zip that second zipper yet, but I'll wait. So the stirrup from the undersuit feels weird to me. It's under my, just in front of my heel, but I think I'll survive. Hey folks, I'm really sorry. I don't know what's up with my camera, but it just shuts off and I don't notice it and I just keep talking and talking. I got the boots on. I have to put the pants over the boots. There's no way I'm gonna tuck them in. The second zipper here, I can't quite zip it all the way. Now, that shouldn't matter. This is all elastic anyway. It's not like I'm gonna miss some sort of leather protection, but I do wanna figure that out. Then, before I put the top on, I'm wearing my back protector. You can see the straps right here, and here, and the belt strap. It's adjustable. It's riding up a little high, but that's all right. After I put the back protector on, I crouch down a little, put my hands through the sleeves, and just kind of put the whole suit on. Now, I have to play with the sleeves. You can see, I mentioned before, the sleeves are long. Kind of annoying. I can cut them maybe an inch, which will help a little bit, but for the moment I'm gonna deal with it the way it is and gonna zip up my suit. Right, everything's in place. Got my gloves. I haven't put my helmet on yet, obviously. I just want to make sure my gloves fit all right. These sleeves are really annoying. I love these gloves. I've had them for years, ridden with them on the street, and now they will be a good addition for the track. There we go. Icon. Icon. Ha ha ha. All right, and then this one. Oh my goodness, it's hot. All right, that's good. Dang sleeves. Come on, glove zipper. You've worked for years. Don't fail me now. There we go. Everything's on. I really do have to work on these boot zippers. It's kind of weird. Although, like I said, for a few years in the MotoGP, they wore them like that, so maybe whoever designed this suit had that in mind. I'm also gonna see, maybe I can adjust where the shin guards go and everything. Okay, I'm gonna shut off the camera. I'll set you up in the garage and I'm gonna go sit on the bike and we'll see how that goes. Hang on. All right. I'm gonna put my helmet on, put my gloves on, and I'm gonna sit on the bike and see how everything feels. Helmet's a good fit. My annoying sleeves. Gloves. Duh. Time on the bike. I feel comfy. Feels good. Hopefully I'll have my rear set soon like this. But for now, ooh, that's going to be a little tough. Getting under that shifter is hard. From the top is okay. Underneath, it's a little weird. I need more flexibility. And this is why you do this. The rear brake is fine. Something's choking me. The helmet was choking me. Anyway, yeah, this is going to be an issue. I can't. That's hard to do. It's doable. It's just going to take some getting used to. All right, not so bad. Sleeves need to be shortened. I got to figure this stupid thing out. It's a little annoying, to be honest with you. I wish I knew that from the beginning. That's it. Time to take all this stuff off. Take a little break, have something to drink, and I'll see you later. All right, hopefully this helps. Let me know if you have any questions. Rock and roll. Hey, really quickly, so I did some experimenting. I couldn't get the pants inside of the boots, right? And then I couldn't zip that one zipper. Well, after a little experimenting, I realized if I zip the zipper that has the fabric on it first, it's then much easier to stretch this, because this is also stretchy material, and zip this open zipper that's open, you know, there's nothing there, and then it zips over the boots and it's very comfy actually, and I feel quite secure, nothing's flapping around, what have you. I just thought you'd like to know that.
I also tried to see if I could move or adjust these, but they're not. They're actually sewn in. They're supposed to be removable. I guess technically they are if you cut out all the stitching. But yeah, so these pants either were designed to wear over your boots or just were poorly designed so you can't get them into the boots. I don't know, but either way, I'm happy all in all. Okay, thought you would like to know. Have a great day, night, whatever time it is you're watching this. Hopefully my info is helping people, and I'm hoping you're excited as I am. That's it. Good night. Subscribe if you haven't, please. I'd really appreciate it. And like, ask questions, anything else I can help you with. All right, take care and see you soon. Bye-bye.